Hey, Bobby Manning here. Welcome to the Garden Report. Josue Pavone by my side. Celtics beat the Hawks in Game 1. Recapped the key points, the rebounding, Jaylen Brown's performance. And Brown spoke after the game after scoring 29 points, double-digit rebounds, 3 assists, saying that in that first quarter when he went to the locker room, we saw him run in there for a few minutes. His cut opened up again, split open. Had to go get a new bandage, as Joe Mazzulla said. And he played the rest of the game looking good. At least from inside. He played aggressively. Yeah. He had that cutting dunk, which was the most encouraging moment physically for him in this game. But the shot looked tentative at times, and he did mention after the game some issues handling the ball. Here's what he had to say on that.
Jaylen, with the hand, you said you expected a little bit of a different feel. You're wearing something to manage the pain. How did that end up working out for you during the game?
It's a constant adjustment, you know, making sure I get a good grip on the ball. I had 6 turnovers tonight, so I definitely got to clean that up, and that's really it.
Is it just kind of like a pain you feel when you're dribbling, or you were able to throw down a dunk at one point? Like, just kind of how was the pain management as the game progressed?
It's fine, you know, especially with the adrenaline in the game, you kind of just get it going. But at times throughout the game, I had to, you know, readjust it, you know, and stuff like that. I got a lot of padding on it, so it's a different feel shooting the ball, just adjusting and adapting to the game. That's it.
CLNS Media Celtics coverage is brought to you by FanDuel. Sign up at FanDuel.com/Boston and make every moment more on America's number one sports book.
So overall, when you look at Jaylen's performance here, how do you think he handled that ailment?
He did the best to his ability. I mean, the first quarter, you can tell that he was favoring it a bit. He was kind of trying to go left on during the fast break on layups, and then he started to go to his right a little bit, but then he was sort of either trying to massage it or get, and my guess is that maybe the wrap that he had on just wasn't allowing him to get a better feel for the basketball. Whatever they did, it helped because you saw a difference. That confidence, I mean, you can't really fake that, especially a dunk the way he did it in the manner that he did it here at TD Garden. And that was a big reason why not only did he get a standing ovation or a big applause from the crowd because of the dunk itself, but also because everyone knows that what he's dealing with. So hopefully this particular bandage is something different than what he had at the start, because if it wasn't, then what's the difference, right? Maybe it's a matter of tightening it or a matter of him getting more comfortable with it. Whatever it is, there's enough time between game 1 and 2 for them to figure that out. But I think the encouraging sign is that the later half of his performance was way more encouraging than his first half.
Yeah, he said it took constant adjustment. He will get that reopened cut assessed tomorrow.
Yeah.
You have to think there might be stitches involved again.
Most likely.
You don't worry about him getting out there. I think no matter what, especially as you said, the 2 days off,
right,
he'll play. You just wonder how limited he'll be, especially if he does enter a game with stitches in, because he got them out on Thursday. It's a concern. He didn't play at his peak form in this game. It's impressive how well he played, but you see clearly on the shot, that's impacted at times. But he, as you said in the clip there, blamed the 6 turnovers, most on his inability to get a feel on the ball, and he already doesn't have the strongest handle to begin with. But when you're forced to go to your left more often, your unnatural side, when you're forced to use that to handle more often, it's going to cause some limitations. It's just that physically the Hawks can't keep up with him. He was able to get by them so quickly. He had 2 back cuts that just left guys in the dust in this game.
Yeah, plus this is intel that's going to help the Hawks, right? I mean, the Hawks are going to do their best to force him to make him uncomfortable, right? Make him use that right hand. Yeah, make him go right over and over again, where you're supposed to do the opposite. But in this case, you want to see how he responds to that. And if you're Atlanta, that's absolutely what you should do, especially in that first quarter. I mean, again, this is intel that is available for everyone, and you wouldn't be doing your proper due diligence if you weren't going to do that in game 2. I mean, you have to change your coverage on Jaylen Brown. But then again, the Celtics has so many weapons in this game that I just feel like the Hawks, it's really on them to execute on the offensive end of the floor, right? It's really up to them to figure out a way to get through the Celtics' defense, because this is the kind of defense that I think the Celtics, this is the biggest reason why I had this team sweeping the Atlanta Hawks, because of the options that the Celtics have on offense, but also because of how tough they can be on defense against guys, younger guys, like, you know, that play on the Atlanta Hawks that can easily struggle when you have that type of resistance.
My biggest concern is that this will persist throughout the playoffs. I don't know if there's enough time for it to fully heal.
You wonder how it's going to heal, that's the thing.
Yeah, while he's playing day in and day out. And you do have two days between games for now. End of the series, it's that one day off. And you don't want to end up in a place where he'll miss time, because I think as dominant as they were tonight, and we talked about this coming into the series, they need his forcefulness. They need his shots around the rim. They need him in that second half when Tatum started 0-for-5.
Yeah, he's got to be a constant threat on offense. I mean, that's what makes the Celtics so hard to defend, when you have Jaylen doing that, and then you have Jason Tatum who can get hot like he did in that first quarter. And of course, it can carry over. These guys can switch off in terms of taking over a game. But what makes Jaylen so explosive is the fact that what he does in transition, right? So when you capitalize on the Atlanta Hawks' misses the way the Celtics did, that's easy buckets for Jaylen. And those can come in a hurry.
Jaylen Brown, he'll get reassessed tomorrow. We'll check up with him on Monday. For now, a dominant performance. Couldn't have asked for more, given his injury status coming into this game. Yeah. Marcus Smart, I asked him how hard it can be, forgetting that he had his own hand.
Yeah, man, I wish I was there for that, man. I would have thought you were being funny too, man.
That's great. Let's play that clip.
Jaylen going through what he's going through. I don't know if you've ever dealt with anything like a cut on your hand. How tough is that to play?
Extremely tough, especially on that shooting hand. But you know, the good thing about us is, we get paid a lot of money to come out here and play. And our whole lives we've been through adversity. And so this is just another obstacle for JB, and he's gonna own it. And he's not gonna allow that to stop him, and he's not gonna use it as an excuse.
All right, yeah, Marcus, I forgot about the glass in his hand.
That's hilarious. I'm glad you brought that up, man. It's definitely
worth shooting hand too.
It's worth mentioning. Yeah, of course. I mean, that was something that Celtics fans immediately thought of when the news initially dropped. But heading into this game, though, it may have been a talking point for some people, Jaylen's injury, but it really wasn't, because I don't think it was that much of a concern. Now it's a thing. The fact that it split open the way it did is certainly a thing. But yeah, I'm glad you were able to have that laugh with Marcus, because he knows a bit about that. And speaking of, I'm glad you brought up Marcus, man. I just want to just squeeze this in before we wrap up this segment. We forgot about playoff Marcus Smart. Or
defensive.
Most people did.
Player of the year, Marcus.
Right, but just in general, like, this guy takes his game to another level during the postseason. Maybe we took that for granted. Maybe there's just so many other talking points, so many other storylines surrounding this series that we forgot that, but he reminded us in game one.
Tatum said after the game,
that was a heck
of
a performance.
Yeah,
we do. And the Celtics, his teammates take it for granted. The way we analyze his game, sometimes we take that for granted, what he does in this postseason. But I won't make that mistake again, man. Shout out to Marcus Smart. Heck of a performance. Game one performance, getting it done on both ends of the floor, and giving you those game-winning plays, regardless of what the scoreboard looks like.
Great to see him fresh. He looked healthy. He looked active. He looked explosive defensively tonight, and he dominated the Celtics' defense in their win. They led by many as 30, slips to 13 in the second half. They closed it out anyway with great plays from Jaylen Brown, who finished this game despite the re-injury to his hand. We'll have updates on that on CLNS Media. Check out all the reaction post-game to that as well, and check out our next video on Robert Williams, who had as big of an impact as Marcus Smart here defensively for the Celtics in this win.